So how would you define camp?
It's like usually during the summer, and you go, what?
You sit outside.
Stay overnight, fires, counselors, mm-hmm. Hot dogs, sometimes a little diddling, you
yeah.
know what I mean?
Yeah.
How would you define
camp? Well, camp is like feeling it and looking it right in the eye and saying, you know what, girl? I'm fierce, and I'm a camp diva, and I'm here to let you know what time it is, what tea it is, and what truth it is, honey, because camp isn't something you define. It's something you live, you serve, you inhabit, and you flourish within.
Honey, that is the true essence of camp.
Hi, I'm Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
That's right, we are.
And today we're watching an incredible new Netflix program called
Survival of the Thickest.
It's a program with Michelle Buteau from many other programs.
Many other programs. Studio regular.
Yes.
Yeah, Netflix diva.
We see her at the Christmas party. Now, this show is either going to be about people who are plus size
mm-hmm.
or about the diameter of my cock. I can't wait to find out.
Do you like spoiled? I don't. So you shouldn't let us spoil it for you. Go watch it and then come back to us later. We'll still be here looking glamorous and wonderful.
What about people drinking like aloe?
Excuse me,
lumps of aloe? Mary, people drinking aloe water with lumps in it. Probiotics.
No, 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 no.
Lumps of
that's
it.
That's bacterial algae. That's Lady of the Lake.
Get a personality.
Thank you.
Get a personality. Then you don't have to do whack.
You don't
for
have,
attention.
You don't have to squeeze a raw meat into your mouth on Instagram with your panties like down around your ankles. Sorry, that was me. We're gonna meet our protagonist, Mavis, at an Essence photo shoot.
Right off the top, hate the name. Mavis, it's a nursing home name.
It is. Mavis, Edna, Agatha,
yeah.
Roberta.
Mavis, yeah. Your granddaughter's visiting.
I hate her.
So she's at the photo shoot as a junior stylist and her boyfriend is the photographer. This is a power dynamic that I don't think is probably great for her, but we'll see.
You see this right here?
It's stressful enough to pick out my own. Picking out things for other people, I could never take it. You and I have been on things where they style us. Rings I can't fit, dresses I can't fit.
Yeah, shoes.
We can't fit anything.
Yeah, I was like, hi, I'm not sure if you received the memo, which had numbers on it, numbers that correspond to my human body, and you overlooked the fact that I'm a man. Now we're gonna watch her save the day with her ingenuity, attracting the attention of the big boss.
You ready, baby?
I got you.
Her physique. Boyfriend, the photographer.
Now, come on.
Oh,
wow.
Oh, love that. Fun. Although, they could have just plugged in a fan, but that's cool.
Mark that one. Mark that one. You know what? Just mark them all.
Okay, they're not that great.
No, they're...
like, we all need to live in reality
but
here.
I love flowing fabric. It's like catnip for me.
By the way, no photo shoot of me as ever. Just mark them all.
She didn't take a bad photograph. It's like man, troll, ugly.
Obviously, it's time for Mavis to move to lead stylist. Didn't you say you were doing a layout with Lizzo's dancers?
Well, that would be a pretty high-profile piece for your first lead job. But
when I saw you throwing fabric laying on the ground, yeah. I knew you could handle Lizzo.
Yeah.
What is that?
We hate photo shoots. I mean, I know that must sound strange because we look so beautiful.
The night before a photo shoot, my mood is at an all-time low. I cannot take it. And you know what? Every photographer I work with, we get the shot in 10 minutes or less.
Yeah, but you're good at modeling, though. And Mrs. Magoo over here, it's like I step into a lady's dress for the first time ever out of the swamp.
No, I'm going to do you.
Do
and
me.
I think that's okay.
Do me. It's fine.
Okay.
It's going to be
It's sort
so
of like you step in a frame and they go, all right, start modeling. And you're sort of like,
yep. But now cock the head, but don't change the face. There you go. Audience, please be advised that the following scene could be detrimental to your entire mental health from now on for the rest of your life. It's betrayal.
Yep.
It's cheating.
For like 42 whole ass
minutes. Oh no.
She is so pretty.
Here we
I
go.
Love her.
Oh! She didn't catch that.
Baby, Jesus Christ, what are you doing home?
You don't hear the door. You know when you're committing a crime, your ears are perked up a little bit. As a crime doer, I know. Do you know what I mean? You're
that
very
pussy's
aware.
Not so bomb that you go deaf.
Exactly.
You can't hear the door.
Mama, and you go to her house. Get a grip.
Don't
hit her.
Don't hurt her.
The model?
Violence.
Rip the wig off.
What is she doing with her neck? What the f was that?
I don't know.
People need to learn a little bit of karate. A little jujitsu.
What would you have done
classes.
There?
Well, not violence.
Yeah.
I'd be like, oh, you're having sex with a woman in my bed. Let's talk about that. Or not. I'll just go.
Straight people's relationship with cheating is psycho.
Take off your, like, lice-ridden medieval coat. And do you know what I mean? And stop f***ing that sheep in the agrarian wilderness.
Yes.
Like, get it together.
You have your Goody Proctor Puritan like, little flying nun hat
yeah,
on.
Yeah, what are you doing?
Well, if you really loved me, you'd only ever be attracted to me.
Yeah,
if like, you really loved me. Khalil helps Mavis pack up and move out of the apartment.
Any model version of me? Like, how fucking hurtful and basic.
Oh, yeah, that's
I get
tough.
It. I
of
get
course,
it.
That's tough.
I do get it.
If I, you know, caught my man with somebody much younger, it would, you know.
Well, the thing is, if you're being cheated on by someone who is older than you, whatever, then it's just puzzling. If you're being cheated on by somebody you believe is much more attractive right. than you, yeah. it is more hurtful.
Yeah.
If someone cheats on someone like me, a thick girl,
I got a newsflash for you, sister.
Everyone's getting
cheated on. Beyonce got cheated on.
Mavis, can we please talk?
No, bitch, it's over. I wish I was in there with her.
So Mavis and Khalil take all of her and haul it up the stairs of a New York City walk-up.
I'm moving you to Brooklyn to live with a total stranger.
Mama, John. She's got a bolo and two hats on. This is me going to drag race. This is when I couldn't fit all my in the luggage.
In Milwaukee, I lived on a four-story walk-up. Mm-hmm. Me, multiple nights a week with all my dragon suitcases up and downstairs. Four floors. Four floors. And my roommate at the time, Reed, would come down and help me every time.
That's really nice.
I know.
I lived in a third floor walk-up, and there were two old Italian sisters. One of them died on the toilet. I told you about that.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Mavis! Hi! Where's my bedroom? Right behind you.
Oh, I've had a bedroom with French doors that lead out to the living room. That's hookups are a struggle. Mama. We're talking hanging bath towels on the windows.
Honey.
While my roommate's watching Harry Potter. Do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean.
Mary.
I just touched this chair, and now there's a greasy film inside of my hand.
It's just olive oil. I just put it all over my body, my hair, all the time. It's so wonderful.
You're kidding me.
Anytime like my body needs love, I rub it in. Mm-hmm. Like a little pasta dish, you know?
Like a little pasta dish?
I'm all for unconventional beauty hacks. Why are we rubbing olive oil?
Like a bowl of pasta?
I'll also say, like, he's a little out of pocket for saying something.
He's
he
rude.
Just walked into her house and said that.
He's very rude.
You never mentioned you had a cat.
That's gonna be a problem for me, because now you're dealing with a bucket of shit in the house.
His full name is Cocaine Xavier.
I love all animals. I'm not doing cats.
We're not doing any animals.
Yeah.
I'm the dog. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I'm making the mess.
If anybody's scraping their butt across this carpet, it's me.
Yeah, if anybody's clawing the curtains at 3 a.m.
Yeah. If anyone's chewing on this bedpost, I pay the mortgage. Mavis has two friends, Khalil, who we know, and Marley. Mm. Marley helps Mavis create a vision board.
Which is very important for people who are struggling in their careers.
When someone says, you want to come over and make a vision board? you say no. Do you think cutting out a piece of paper from a magazine is going to turn your life around?
Well, we all have to start somewhere, right?
I'm sorry for everyone at home. Because they're acting like this apartment is like a spider hole in Kuwait.
This is a $17 million property.
You know, could Marie Kondo take a lap?
Absolutely.
Of course. It's not a shithole.
Oh, man, what's more realistic, 100,000 followers or fucking Lenny Kravitz?
Oh, wow. I'll do a vision board with her.
I'm changing my whole tune. If Marley said, you need a vision board, I go, yes, I do.
And this energy that you're spending on him, I need you to spend on you.
She's a great friend, but take it with a grain of salt. She's like, you are everything, girl, but your house is nasty.
You are a wonderful diva goddess who deserves, like, the world, but you are a piece of shit. Like, you smell like trash, but you are beautiful.
Yeah.
Catch it.
She meets up with Khalil and finds out about a potential styling opportunity because she does need a job.
Yes.
The table's all ready.
No, can we just stop? I love everyone. Get the drag queens to play drag queens. Girl, they couldn't call Peppermint and Sasha Ballard.
Yo, this spot is crazy.
Oh, it's like Lips.
Right? Lips is a famous restaurant in New York where they do lip syncing. It's like dinner theater, but with drag queens. My first drag show, Peppermint was the waitress.
Hello?
Peppermint!
This is crazy.
I will
this
no longer crazy. Stand here and this have you not act like I am psychic.
This is crazy, though. I literally, that's the first time. She was the first person I saw in drag at the.
Is this your autobiography?
This is Peppermint.
Playing herself.
She looks gorgeous. Do you know what we would look like in this lighting?
Like the Babadook.
Yes.
In like Burl Ives.
Only Peppermint. Low table lighting, and she's still like.
Glowing.
If you don't know, this is Peppermint. She's like a legend.
What, for real?
I normally would not recommend anybody work for the bitch. I have known her since I was a young drag princess.
That must be so crazy for Peppermint, who actually did this for a living.
She's got a tongue ring still.
I know.
She's
holding on. Mary, she's holding on to that 2001. Mary, she's holding on to it. She will not let it go.
Do you know how people with tongue rings, like,
they play with it.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow, so good to see you. Mavis goes for a job interview and signs an NDA. No dick allowed.
And I have a passion for fashion.
I don't know about the passion for fashion with this 13-year-old twee little bar mitzvah outfit.
That's a little much. I'm overcompensating because I'm nervous.
I can slap you if you want.
Now we have a gay!
I'm Bruce. Sign here, please.
This is a show about fashion, so I'm the gay Jew. Yep. Sign here. That's kind of what it's giving.
Stanley Tucci wasn't available, so here I am.
Is this Natasha Carina's house? Oh my God.
Is it Garcelle? Oh, work.
She's my most favorite supermodel from the 90s.
No, not from the 90s, from the today's.
Oh, okay, Tamara.
You don't want to meet someone and say you're my favorite person from the 90s.
Especially when you've just walked through their hallway that's filled with glossy 800 by 10,000 foot pictures of themselves.
On the cover of Vogue.
Yeah.
I thought I asked for a stylist, not a cartoon mouse.
Cartoon mouse? Maybe.
In order to work with people, you do have to be a person and act like a person. Jesus, I met Garcelle a few weeks ago and I feel better about the way I handled it based on this.
All right, Mavis gets the gig, but she has to shop for someone who will not reveal their clothing size.
I need to feel sexy.
I love that weird circular couch. People who don't like each other can sit around.
Gotcha. All I have to do is get your measurements.
Oh, that's a no.
As a person who wants to waste as least time as possible, I want you to know everything. Part of my body. Because I want it to come back perfect.
But this is a person who's literally like,
it's your stylist.
It's your stylist. It's like,
you're in your house, in your closet, in a kimono.
It's like lying to your doctor. It's like, why would you lie
to
your doctor?
Well, that's fine.
Yeah, it's like, no, my kidneys are fine.
When my doctor would say, how many drinks do you have a week? And I go, 2,000.
It will take 2 inches off my waist.
Is that a straitjacket?
It's a corset.
She's a stylist and has never seen a corset. By the way, that's not how you put a corset on.
Over a f***ing dressing gown? What the f*** is wrong with you?
If I dress you, there's no corset.
She's giving an ultimatum. I think she's being ridiculous.
She said yes.
Oh my God.
Don't F it up.
Good luck, girl. I'm going to brunch. Kisses.
What's this thing?
I got a job.
Girl, what club you dancing at?
They got wings.
Love this friend. If this is how your friend treats you when you're down and out,
this is
I want to know how this friend
this
treats you when you're
wild.
Feeling good.
It's so fierce.
Don't be looking at me like that, Ronald. You know you love the flat top.
Love her.
Y'all get your dicks out, put them on the table, we're going to measure them. Hey, girl, you suck any dick today? No, I'm in a board meeting, it's cool. Like,
what? Mavis goes to the designer that does all the looks for the drag queens to help with Natasha. By the way, for the plus size divas.
That's what you
want.
The
drag queen designers know how to get you together. They do.
As brilliant and as wonderful as these couturiers are, like John Galliano, Alexander McQueen, let me see them dress Eureka. Let me see them put Mistress Isabel Brooks in something.
Yeah.
The short
or
circuit
us.
Happens. Yeah.
We're big to these people.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Should we just say what it's gonna be? Mm-hmm. I think it's gonna be some cleavage here,
yeah.
Off the shoulders. It's
a
gonna
slit.
Have a little nipped little waist.
Maybe a glove.
Yeah.
A slit.
And a slit.
A slit.
That's what
floor
it's gonna be. Let's just say it.
So Mavis goes to the big event with Natasha and Bruce, and it is not what she is expecting. Do you feel any type of way getting nude and naked in front of people in this, like, in this kind of situation, like a fitting or whatever?
I think my level of comfort is unfair to unleash on other people.
Yeah, yeah.
Because
yeah.
They might not want to see me naked.
Right.
Couldn't imagine that, but.
I prefer, well, I'm Catholic, so I'll just say that.
So you want an old man in the room?
Only.
Yes.
I need a corset.
No, you don't.
No, I need a corset.
You don't need a corset.
I do.
Oh, no, 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 no. We're not doing this. We're not doing this.
It's fine.
By the way, Garcelle can wear anything and look gorgeous.
You know what? I went to a phone party here back in the desert.
I'm just going to say it. I don't think she's the most professional, Mavis. Shut your mouth.
She is straight up and down. I'd be like, girl, shut the f*** up for a minute, okay? With love. Oh, she looks great, though.
She does.
Hold up. Is this one of them rich people birthday parties where they pretend they're dead?
Is it a funeral?
This is my ex-husband's funeral.
Mary, we're not really. We're looking Cam straight in the butt. You know? That's what
Mary,
we're doing.
What is happening? I do believe that camp has to be self-aware. So when something is bad and we call it camp, that's a misuse of the word.
How does my cleavage look? Sitting pretty like two fucking coconuts.
Work, bitch. And she's wearing gloves. You knew it.
I knew it.
He discovered me when I was a hot little waitress. I was very slutty. But he meant modeling.
What? What?
God. If you're there, please strike me dead. I'm 41 years old. I've had a good run.
Yeah, I know.
This is a reality in which I do not wish to live.
And even though he left me for that.
By the way, as if Peppermint knows how to use that feature on a phone. Peppermint might have a new phone, but she's using it the old school way.
Thank you. And also, she is so gorgeous, you forget that she is 72 years old.
Yeah. I know.
So we're airing laundry at the funeral.
That's what it is.
Yes. Mavis, Marley, and Khalil go back to CeCe Bloom's where we get treated to a number by Peppermint.
By the way, CeCe Bloom's, it's the name of Bette Midler's character in Beaches.
Took their treasures with them to the afterlife.
Okay. This is something drag queens would
do. Yes, this is what they would do. They did what drag does so well. They take a turd and they put a bunch of rhinestones on it and make it look good.
Yeah.
They took that challenging monologue, set it to a house beat, and then it sounds somehow a little more audible. In addition to styling Natasha, Mavis has also started styling drag queens. Lord knows we need the help and never do it ourselves.
And if I know one thing about drag queens is that they have the money for stylists.
Yes.
They always do.
Yeah.
By the way, huge dressing room for drag queens.
Y'all look good. Oh, wait. Oh, Marley.
Also, imagine looking at that woman and not brushing the wig first. Oh, I see what's wrong here. You're short.
I actually kind of like this atmosphere. Oh,
roll
no.
Oh, because she has a real boob.
Yeah.
Interrupt your date.
We are not dating.
I need your time.
Well, we know from the first episode that she is not afraid to get in there, ingenuity, fix it.
She's pulling his jock strap off through his hands, and she's going to put it on her titty. The guy who Mavis borrowed the tie from, his name is Luca. He's from Italy, and he asked her out on a date that very night.
This is a Queens only area.
That's for real. I'm going to tell you what the reality is behind that curtain.
It's not this.
It's not a wig on. Oh. Gollum got into a pool, just jumped out of a pool, and is looking for some, like, her pearl necklace.
Yeah. One flickering night bulb, a wet floor, walls that are dyed brown from dark hairspray.
Yeah. A note from the management that says, don't ask for any more money, you grateless bitches.
Treat your dressing room like your own space.
Yeah.
Imagine the biggest, meatiest, sweatiest high school football player.
Yeah.
Walks back after practice and sprays on a $10 Victoria's Secret
pink
body
sugar,
spray.
Pink sugar.
That's what it smells like.
He drags his fungus balls out.
Yeah, he pulls the dick up to expose where the balls and the dick meet.
Yeah, and never washed that space before in his life.
Yeah, and he takes a cherry chapstick and draws some circles around it.
Yeah. And then he takes a fan and blows the air right into your mouth.
It's some man sweating, hunched over a table like this, uncrumpling singles.
Yeah.
And by the way,
mouth
and then,
breathing with bad breath, just had a cigarette. It's disgusting.
And then some girl listening to the song that she's about to do because she hasn't learned.
For the first time.
I love everyone.
Yeah.
Don't come back there if you're not on the show.
It's mildew, it's mold, it's humiliation, degradation, and absolute intolerable suffering.
Luca and Mavis have their first date.
All the models were so rail thin and white. You could see their veins through their skin. It's just like, girl, you okay?
Don't talk about me like I'm not here.
Have some butter and bread, bitch.
And I will eat butter and bread.
I'm really worried about you.
Can I have bread and butter hold the bread?
Oh,
Mateo Lane?
Mateo is one of the funniest comics.
So funny.
The and hottest people.
The brain doesn't want that to compute.
No.
Because, like, you cannot have both, you f***.
Sì, dico io. Il menu, per favore.
I'd be like, say it to my face,
I work for a nonprofit that resettles refugees.
What do you do?
Well, I own four or five capitalist ventures based around me.
Sorry. My ovaries were just high-fiving, and I had to let them do what they need.
What's happening? This is warm.
Yeah. Nature's little oven. Sometimes you want to take a pause between a thought and then a sentence. Do you know what I mean?
So Mavis is sucking his dick,
yeah,
and she gets her chewing gum in his pubes. So now something we can actually relate to.
But here's you. You take the gum out, you stick it right up his ass.
But if he's that hairy in the front, you know his backside's a wicker basket.
No kidding.
Why are they acting like he's having cardiac arrest?
Yeah. Like his femoral artery just got gashed and he's gonna bleed out in 13 seconds.
Yeah, cut the pubes.
Because he's Italian, if he cuts the pubes, people will think he's a woman.
Italian men are so hairy, it will grow back by morning.
No, it's a different country. Things work differently there, trust me.
You think?
Va bene.
So Natasha wants Mavis to style her for her dog's upcoming wedding. Rich people do love to do weird for their dog. So this, I believe.
A wedding, though.
It's a
wedding. Kristen's.
Kristen. Karina.
Kristen's also a weird name for a dog.
I love regular human names for dogs.
Kristen. Like my dog Richard. Kristen.
My dog Richard. My cat Terry. Paul. Yeah, Paul, Jason.
The wedding is happening, and Mavis's ex is gonna take the photos.
Mavis Beaumont, you're finally here.
Michelle!
Oh my God! We got a lot of phone calls to make after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is pop diva Michelle Visage from the band Seduction, the first interracial girl group, by the way. And, author, mother, yep. Host of Drag Race, Emmy winner.
Cease and desist receiver from none other than Madonna.
You make Natasha look better than me. I'll kill you in your sleep and host a fundraiser to
Damn. She said the same thing to me, and our show's unscripted.
What the fuck?
Okay, so she hasn't processed.
Unprofessional.
Yeah.
Unprofessional.
So Mavis has a little discussion with Jacques.
What do we have to talk about? You stuck your dick in that haunted toothpick of a woman.
I don't know.
I don't understand any of what she's saying.
I don't know. Sometimes you want to, like, serve, but you haven't thought about what you're going to say.
Well, there's no food on the plate.
Yeah.
You can't serve when there's no food on the plate. You know what I mean? Marley has been hooking up with her trainer, and her trainer wants to be in a threesome with him and his girlfriend.
Hey, you told me you guys were in an open relationship.
Her hair and makeup at the gym is, it's a fantasy.
It is.
It's a farce and a fantasy.
This is a sci-fi channel. This is Guardians of the Galaxy.
Because I'm telling you, even people who look like her
Mama,
don't wear their hair like that.
Down
wet shoulders.
While you're sweating? Are you out of your mind?
Ew.
It's up.
The thing is, we don't want to leave you out.
Would you do that? I would.
I think it'd be more like me and her having sex with him. Because I've had a lot of three ways. In my opinion, if sex with you doesn't take two sets of hands, you're not doing it right. I got six holes. Now. I'm a grown girl. Oh, at the gym?
Oh, wow. Let's see. Okay. Ew, no. You got two fine women and you're checking your phone?
I'm sorry. I forgot I got another session. Can we try this another time?
You canceled the session.
Mama.
Y'all are way more professional than me.
They're gonna Let's take this party downtown. Come on.
Oh. Yes.
Sisters doing it for themselves.
I'm gonna be honest. They might have a little more fun without him.
Yes, girl, of course they will. The dogs get married and it really has an emotional impact on Mavis.
And this marching jacket, it's crazy. She's a stylist.
She's a stylist. And she looks like she's Janet Jackson for H&M.
Gather here today to celebrate the joining of Tootie and Kristen.
By the way, I bet they called Michelle and said, you're gonna play a really glamorous rich cunt who is having a dog wedding. Michelle's like, sign me up.
North Korean funeral wailing at a dog wedding.
Crazy. Buffalo Bill.
Yeah.
Don't you marry my dog. It's like, what the f-? So Marley talks to her therapist about
the sex.
And her newfound lesbianism.
I had a threesome today.
That's not a threesome.
That's a duo, mama.
Let's talk about representational frameworks. You grew up with hetero parents.
This is how the baristas talk to you in Portland.
Oh my God.
Do you know what I mean? If you go to a Starbucks
I just
Portland,
wanted an oat milk latte. Yeah, that's... What have you thought?
Can I just get like an iced tea with a shot of syrup? Have you talked about your queerness today?
And what is the representational framework of this latte?
Maybe aspects of your identity worth exploring that have been out of reach to you because...
Well, yeah, she's...
If you can sleep with a woman one-on-one and you can call that a threesome, you do have mental blocks. Yeah. There was two people in the room.
Is that person in the room with us now?
I know. I would also have a conversation with her about counting.
Counting one.
So you got one. Then you got two.
But then what?
And the three's
next?
Over here.
What does your queerness look like when men are removed from the equation?
She looks down at her notes. She goes, so how long have you been a bull dagger?
Don't come for me like that.
How long have you been a complete and utter work boot wearing cutoff t-shirt, denim jeans, bull dagger?
So how long have you led the d*** march?
Are you friends with Ani DeFranco?
When was the first time you came to the window?
Mavis goes to see Jacques, and he wants her back, but she wants that Japanese toilet, which is
that
a term for a type of sex.
Yes.
Japanese toilet.
Are you wearing my shirt?
He cheated on her, and he enters the door wearing an empowered women's shirt.
He's got her panties on, too.
Are you back?
No, bitch.
No, I'm not back. I came here because I want to tell you...
I need my Japanese toilet.
...that you were right.
Are they f***ing? I think she needs to stand by her guns. She's feeling vulnerable, and he's hot. But girl, yeah. You left for a reason.
Grab the Japanese John and get the hell out of there.
Fine, I'll let you do the Japanese toilet one more time. And then he pulls both his nuts in her ass and then pulls it out and puts it in her mouth and pisses in her eyes. That's the Japanese toilet. It sounds like a filthy sex act, doesn't it?
Oh.
She's like, the Japanese toilet, all right, one more time. For old time's sake, she pulls out her contacts, both his nuts in her ass.
Oh,
then she pushes him out. She births them.
Shut up. Oh, fucking hell.
Now we're getting somewhere.
She doesn't blow ass on the subway.
If she doesn't go.
And then it's like a bend and snap moment like, with everybody uses the toilet.
Everyone in a row. And it's not connected to anything, so it just fills up. We had a city on tour. It not only had a bidet, but it blew air to dry your butt. When you walk up to it, the lid would open.
I was like, you don't have to do all that.
Also, you don't know what I'm doing.
Exactly.
I could just be coming in here.
Thank you. You say, do I need
That's my other problem with automatic flushing. I'll decide when I'm done. Exactly. I'll decide.
Midstream, it's like, don't rush me.
No.
Don't rush me. I'm going at my own pace. I'm in the airport. I feel a little shy.
Also, if I'm pooping, just because I got up doesn't mean it's time to flush. I could just be stretching.
And don't expect me. So Mavis and Luca are looking more closely at their relationship. Well, we know we're from Roma in the New York. It's hard.
I do get bummed every time I go on a trip, leaving my boyfriend.
Yeah, it sucks.
What's funny is by the time I'm at the airport, I've like forgotten my normal life. Like I just adjust, but leaving my house, I always feel depressed. David, when I'm on tour, I either have to call him first thing in the morning or like 2 a.m.
I know, it's tough. That the whole like Australia thing is like, it's tough.
Australia is
very
tough. Another world.
It's another world.
You're right.
Different time. Time changes. There's a time zone where it's different 30 minutes.
Did you know there's an ocean under?
Do you know there's a tunnel under Ocean Boulevard?
He made you something.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
This is so crazy. Marissa Jarrett Whittaker auditioning to play Serena Williams. By the way, I love that she's presenting herself like,
hey, girlfriend.
This is Emily in Paris, Texas.
Yes. Mavis lands her second celebrity client.
I love her hair like that.
Oh,
fire. When she sees me watching this.
Delete contact.
Nicole is gorgeous. Work,
oh,
bitch.
Oh, wow, the hair is lovely.
By the way, not even the biggest hair I've seen Nicole in. Nicole is not a stranger to a big wig.
You know how to make us cute little fatties look good. Who better than the woman who made Natasha Carina look gorgeous while dropping a strap on into a casket?
Nicole is this all the time. Nicole's not playing Nicole, this is Nicole.
Natasha will be walking the red carpet at the Webbies.
Which we have won 3 for the show.
Did we walk the red carpet?
We didn't go.
Okay.
We have won a Webby Award for my speech from Bradley's funeral.
What?
Work, bitch.
Can I please have this bracelet?
I don't care.
Okay, Peppermint's bringing the comedy.
Can I please have this bracelet?
It's not a stretch to say that I made you.
It's crazy.
Actually, I started the hashtag.
There's some necklaces over there.
She's doing Looney Tunes.
Oh, yeah.
She's doing Hanna-Barbera. Natasha gives Mavis an ultimatum. She has to choose the fashion show or her.
Girl, that's not the way you treat your stylist that has other gigs.
It's not
a double cross that she took a gig. That being said, when wig people aren't available today for me, I get ornery.
I want you to be my stylist exclusively.
Let's talk.
Thank you.
Let's talk turkey, bitch.
I'm trying to grow my brand. I'll give you a monthly salary. How's 10,000?
I don't know, I might take it.
I mean. Well, it depends if she's like carrying a toilet on the subway, then.
Mavis, if you walk out that door.
Be reasonable, Natasha.
There's no coming back.
Nicole definitely seems more fun to style for than that bitch, though.
Yeah.
You know? So all the stress got to Mavis and she had a panic attack.
Oh my God, what are you doing here?
What is he doing there?
Okay, let me just try one last thing, okay?
Okay.
Irregular breathing can also sometimes cause.
When did our careers become downwardly mobile? When did we start watching fart content? I think this type of comedy is actually hard.
Yes, it is.
And so Mavis is being proposed to.
Girl.
I don't know. Jacques is gorgeous. I do think people make mistakes. But if I was her, I would say we need to find our footing again.
Will you marry me?
Yes.
That's intense.
That is weird.
Yes, my God. I can't believe this is happening.
Girl, neither can we.
Neither can we. Mavis tells Jacques that actually it's not going to work between them.
Do you want to try and fix this? Or do you want an upgrade?
By the way, by New York standards, fabulous customer service.
Absolutely. Also, I think this is a metaphor.
You want to fix the old one, right?
Isn't that right? Don't you want to fix the old one or upgrade to a new one?
I think you hold out for Luca.
Love you. Jacques, I can't be with you anymore. I'd like to upgrade to a new one, please.
Listen, nothing heals heartbreak like the iPhone 13. Yeah.
Our screen is cracked. I need a new phone.
We're broken.
Oh.
Okay.
Would you rather have an okay relationship all the time or an amazing relationship some of the time?
The latter.
The amazing relationship.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
I'd rather have 30 minutes of something good than a lifetime of nothing special.
Finally, they're going to have the prom, the out and proud in the clouds. Well, not those clouds. Not those clouds, honey. It's not that kind of gay prom, honey.
Twirlina
Phuket is not available.
Perfect.
It looks amazing.
Cutesy wootsy.
Every gay prom has a straight guy pitching in.
Oh, girl, tonight is the night. It is.
A little.
Miss Blanket, you want to serve camp? She's in the sleeping bag, honey.
Yeah. The awkwardness of filming dance scenes is something
with
that
no
is,
music. With I think about it every
it
time.
It is like,
let's do it. If we were filming a dance scene on this couch now. Don't laugh at me. And I know you're like very anti like gay people having sentimental experiences, but I think people having adult prom experiences to make up for teen proms is fun.
I think that's cute.
Don't yell at me.
Oh my.
So Mavis decides she wants to have it all.
I'm in love with you.
I'm just going to need more time to think.
Yeah. Have you ever said I love you to someone they didn't say it back?
No.
Me neither.
Someone says to me, I said, thank you.
Love that! This is what's gonna happen. She's gonna FaceTime with him and then she's gonna knock on the door and be there. It's tired because it's worn out. It's worn out, it's untreated vintage leather, cracking at the seams.
Mama. It's a sun-bleached rug that nobody's cleaned.
There's formulaic. Buongiorno.
E buongiorno, le valigie, sacco di stitis, you mother.
What was that? What was that? What was that?
What?
It was the Emmy. The Emmy being thrown at the television.
They threw
the Emmy right at the screen because they couldn't wait to give it to these gifted actors and these
that
incredible
was
writers.
So who scary.
Produced the most incredible.
That was
television.
So scary.
Oh! Oh my God! This is a Jennifer. It's a nightmare. Jennifer, it's a nightmare. We can't wake up from.
That scared me.
We've never heard noise from over there.
I know. She was just scared of this ending.
Also, I believe in our talented set team. My brain would have never believed something behind us could fall apart.
Thank God I put panties on today. Well, the show had everything.
It sure did. It had dog weddings.
An absolutely dazzling array of characters played by some unbelievably wonderful people.
Michelle Buteau.
Michelle Visage.
Peppermint.
New York City.
Woo! It had Garcelle.
Italy, the most delicious place on earth.
Love. Triangles.
Threesomes.
Cheating.
Viral moments.
Gay bars.
Drag queens.
I will say this show's talking about that not every show talks about.
So check out Survival of the Thickest right here on Netflix.
Goodbye.
Ciao.
Ciao, babe.
Ciao, bella ragazza.